Hello, everybody, and welcome to the Synology 2022 Connect session. My name is Cody, and I'm going to be your guide for this one this time around. Thank you for taking some time out of your day to look into the future of Synology with us. Throughout 2020, all businesses and individuals had to adjust to a new normal. The COVID-19 pandemic that we endured and continued to endure accelerated some already prevalent work trends that were becoming more apparent over the past decade. Suddenly, you had millions of people worldwide looking to work from home or otherwise remotely, when in the past it might not have been possible to do so. According to a report by S&P Global, 2/3 of organizations now believe that these work-from-home trends are either going to be permanent or at the very least long-term in big technology. This shift in working and e-learning habits has forced many businesses and institutions to rethink their network infrastructure to meet these changing needs. At Synology, this has meant that we both had an opportunity and a chance to further improve our network offerings for all users. And for us, these trends have meant impressive growth in a couple different areas of our connectivity products, one of those being the increased usage of parental controls. Now, we all know the needs for knowing and regulating how kids utilize the internet at home is on the rise. For example, only allowing access to e-learning websites during school hours or imposing a daily time quota online. All told, Safe Access, which is rated by many as the best free parental control on routers ever, saw a 269% increase in overall traffic inside of SRM, making it the most visited package in our router operating system. Another area that we saw impressive growth was the overall increase in VPN Plus license activations. Now, at the beginning of 2020, all businesses and end users had to rush to provide some sort of remote work option for their workforce, and they had to do so in the quickest and most secure way possible. So recognizing this, Synology decided to offer the VPN Plus licenses for free starting in April of 2020. All told, we saw 246,000 license activation inside of our VPN Plus server, making it the second most visited package inside of SRM, besides Safe Access, of course. Now, originally, this option for free VPN Plus licenses were slated to expire in September of 2021. However, at Synology, we recognize that remote and hybrid work styles have become the new normal for many organizations. And in light of the large number of activations inside of our VPN Plus server, we think that this functionality should become the default for any Wi-Fi routers into the future, free of charge, of course. So, starting in September, Synology is now offering VPN Plus licenses for free forever for all Synology router users. Now, this general increase in over VPN Plus license activations and the increased prevalence of remote work meant that maximizing the throughput available to the VPN Plus server became a high level of priority here at Synology. So, recognizing this, Synology updated SRM to offer a new cipher suite, this being the Cha-Cha cipher suite. In addition to offering the same level of security as AES GCM ciphers, it also offered an up to 47% increase in overall throughput available to the VPN Plus server. Preparing for the future and selecting a router that you expect to serve for you for many years to come, it's going to have a mixture of both security and performance. On the security side of things, as a company that has its roots in data storage and management where security is paramount, Synology has always taken the security of our routers very seriously. And with continued updates to patch emerging vulnerabilities and a wide range of security measures available to it, our best-selling RT2600 AC router has been voted by many in the media as one of the most secure routers in every year since its launch. Let's just take the FragAttacks vulnerability that was very high profile as just one example of this. Now, the FragAttacks vulnerability was a vulnerability discovered in the Wi-Fi standard itself, which meant that it affected pretty much any Wi-Fi-enabled product on the market today. The very same day that this vulnerability was made apparent to the public, Synology had a patch available to SRM to help mitigate that specific vulnerability. And we have been consistently delivering this level of timely response to most critical vulnerabilities in the past few years. Now, also updated in the same year, for users who require the highest level of VPN security, we also have the option for TLS 1.3 only to help safeguard those client connections back to the VPN Plus server. With that said, there's still some other rising threats in the IT industry today. One of those being, of course, IoT devices. Now, Internet of Things devices, as the name implies, require an internet connection to function as intended. However, a lot of times these devices don't have the same level of antivirus, or their security updates might not be very consistent. So oftentimes these devices are utilized as proxies to attack other things on the network once they are compromised. On top of that, bring your own device. While convenient for the end user because you get to use what device you want, they also present some other threats to the corporate network itself. Since users are utilizing their own devices, that means they could potentially use these devices on public Wi-Fi where they could be compromised. When they then bring that compromised device back onto the corporate network, it can be used again as a proxy to attack other devices on the network. Lastly, remote work. The main issue with remote work is around credentials being leaked. And previously, before the pandemic, lots of different sites or resources were internet only. However, now this is not especially possible because remote work is typically a requirement. So these credentials that could be leaked through remote work are typically the only way that accounts or devices are authenticated or verified on the network. Now, there are many solutions, with the most important one being to properly segment your network in order to isolate critical devices from other devices on that same network. This is where SRM 1.3 comes into play, and one of the most significant features in this regard is its ability to have multiple networks and SSIDs applied to the system. Now, let's take this as an example scenario here. You can see we have multiple networks, and they serve multiple different purposes. In addition to just general network segmentation and isolation, you can also impose different firewall rules, internet access policies like through safe access, quality of service rules on top of that, on different networks to serve the endpoints and users that reside within those networks. So let's illustrate how this works and why it's useful. So in this example scenario, you can see we're going to be connecting a Wi-Fi enabled printer back to our network. And typically what many people will utilize is WPS or Wi-Fi protected setup to get this accomplished. While convenient, this might not always be the most secure way to get this done. And with that said, what we're instead going to do is create an isolated IoT network and only enable WPS specifically for that IoT network. So here we are inside of SRM, inside of Network Center. And what we're going to first do is show you that we already have some local networks set up here, and we have some other devices listed inside of our traffic control. However, what we're going to need to do to set up this wireless printer is go ahead and create a dedicated IoT network, as we mentioned. So moving back to local network, we're going to create and label our IoT network. And we're also going to disable network isolation because other segments, other networks inside of our environment are going to need to be able to print from this printer. And we'll get back into how to secure this in just a bit. Now, you can also create your Wi-Fi for this IoT network. So we're going to set up a Wi-Fi network here for IoT and go ahead and apply the password here. Now that we've created this dedicated IoT network, we're going to need to enable WPS specifically for this IoT network here. And we're going to do that under Wi-Fi Connect and Wi-Fi Settings. What you can see here in WPS is that we already have home set up as our main target for WPS, but we're going to change that to IoT in our case, so that if we use this WPS button, it's going to directly connect that device to this IoT network. Now that we have that enabled, you can see that we now have this printer all coming up and ready to go inside of our network. You can see it listed inside of traffic control, and you can begin to impose other rules if you needed to. Now, you might be wondering why we turned off network isolation whenever we're trying to create network segmentation in the first place. And this is actually where we can leverage firewall policies to create a one-way network to keep it secure, even though network isolation is turned off. So one other area that you might expect to utilize a feature like this is in the surveillance deployment. And actually, one in five Synology users actually utilize surveillance station in their environment to monitor camera feeds on their home or business, for example. However, these IP cameras themselves are not often considered the most secure devices on a network. Despite that, the NAS itself still needs to have at least one-way access back to that IP camera so that it can view those camera feeds and it can do other camera operations like audio output or even pan, tilt, zoom. So here we are starting off inside of surveillance station, and you can see that we have access to this environment and it has access back to some IP cameras on top of that. Under traffic control and SRM, you can see we have an IP camera listed as well as a Synology NAS listed on top of that. What we're first going to do is edit our IoT network that we created in the previous demo and apply this to a specific Ethernet port on the router. Once that's all applied, if we go back over to traffic control, you can see now that the IP camera has been paired back to the IoT network specifically. However, what we still need to do is set up some firewall rules to create a truly one-way network. So to do so, what we're going to do is head back down to security, and we're going to go over to firewall and begin setting up a firewall rule. We're going to first go ahead and hit create and set up our source for this specific environment. First, we're going to go ahead and label this IoT one-way so we can easily tell apart these different firewall rules. Under source, we're going to select LAN and have the source be IoT network. And we're going to leave some of the other settings the same. As we scroll down to destination, we're going to apply that to LAN and specifically apply this to our primary network. Since the source is the IoT network and the destination is the primary network, we're going to make the action a deny rule. What this will do is make it a one-way network as described. Now, if we head back up to Surveillance Station, since we're on our primary network right now, we can easily access Surveillance Station and those camera feeds directly inside of this web browser. However, if we go ahead and go back into our Windows environment and change our Wi-Fi network to the IoT network itself, we shouldn't have access back to our Synology NAS or the cameras themselves because we set up that deny rule inside of security and firewall inside of SRM. And as you see here, you cannot connect to Surveillance Station through this IoT network due to those firewalls we set up. And that means that we have created a truly one-way network utilizing SRM 1.3. Now in SRM 1.3, let's go over some of the features that we discussed. You have the ability to have multiple networks and SSIDs to suit different needs, and you can set those as different network types, like a standard network, an isolated network, or even a one-way network like you saw us create with our IoT environment. You can also set up different parental controls and traffic controls for each one of these individual networks. Now in SRM 1.3, you have the option for up to 5 networks and SSIDs, and that should suit most home users and small businesses' needs with that initial setup. However, you can actually turn off Smart Connect and create a 2x5 setup for dual band routers and a 3x5 setup for tri-band routers if you needed that added little bit of flexibility. Now, all these different features inside of SRM that you've come to know and love work with these multiple networks and multiple SSIDs. This includes mesh Wi-Fi mode, so you don't need to go into each individual node and manually create those SSIDs. You just have to set them up on the main Synology NAS so that whenever you actually go to add additional nodes to your environment, it'll begin automatically broadcasting those SSIDs that you had already set up. Now, safe access also works with these multiple networks and SSIDs, and what that means for an IoT network, for example, you can actually create a specific set of internet access rules so that if you pair any additional IoT devices back to that network, it'll immediately adopt those. Lastly, with VPN Plus, it also works with these multiple networks. And what that means is the VPN Plus admin can actually assign what network the VPN users will dial into whenever they utilize the VPN. On top of that, the VPN admins can also set up other firewall rules so that when those users are dialed into that network, they'll be able to access other network segments as they need. Now, another scenario that you see Synology routers utilize is in other business deployments. Now, IT administrators might already have some managed switches in place, and they want to use those alongside the Synology router to effectively connect and manage a larger number of client devices, sometimes across multiple floors. Another scenario that you might see a Synology router utilize is whenever there's already a router or gateway with VLANs enabled and configured in an environment. So Synology routers need to be able to integrate into existing VLAN environments, and IT admins should be able to associate SSIDs that we broadcast to different existing VLANs that might already be set up. Now, all of this is made possible by our support of 802.1Q VLANs, and this is how we are able to integrate with existing equipment like those managed switches. And a quick side note, this is how we actually implemented multiple networks and SSIDs inside of SRM 1.3 was through our support of 802.1Q VLANs. Alongside SRM 1.3, we also updated DS Router to its 2.0 version to make it that much easier to manage your SRM environment while on the go. Taking a look at some of the features here, in DS Router 2.0, you can manage and utilize your VPN internet connection directly from the application itself, meaning that for your VPN connections, for example, you can toggle that on and off directly inside of the application. On top of that, it now is able to manage multiple networks and SSIDs directly from inside of the application. For example, if you only needed to use your guest network for a brief moment or two, you could toggle that on and off through the app. Also has access to different advanced features like port forwarding, traffic controls, and even safe access rules directly from within the DS Router app. Now, arguably one of the most important factors when choosing a router for your environment is the performance available to it. Now, even after the initial hardware release of our routers, Synology still seeks to increase the performance of the routers through software updates. Let's take SRM 1.3 as an example. In SRM 1.3, both the RT2600AC and MR2200AC routers saw an overall increase in their connections per second, or CPS, available to the system, with the RT2600AC specifically seeing an up to 92% increase in overall connections per second with that SRM 1.3 update. But even with these continuous enhancements, we still need to answer a key question, something that was requested repeatedly even before the new standard was approved, and that is, of course, Wi-Fi 6. Now, so many people have been waiting for a new Synology router instead of just purchasing a new Wi-Fi 6 router from any other manufacturer. And this is because of their overall experience with SRM or with other Synology products in general, like a Synology NAS. Let's take one quote from a Synology user as an example. "I've never had a consumer router that was so configurable, performed perfectly, and had a large lifespan on updates. The RT2600AC is the only router I recommend to people in the consumer space. And with this sentiment in mind, we are pleased to announce the RT6600AX router designed for the future of networks." On one hand, on the performance side of things, this is all made possible through its support for the new Wi-Fi standard Wi-Fi 6, giving it a higher available throughput to the endpoints and end users, and also allowing for a higher level of concurrent connections back to the system. On the security side of things, this is all powered by SRM 1.3. Here at Synology, we believe that those trends we mentioned before, like IoT and bring your device, are here to stay, and network segmentation, advanced VPN, granular traffic control should become default on all routers, including for homes, rather than limited to just business-grade network devices. Now, this device offers tri-band Wi-Fi 6 with up to 6,600 megabits per second available for total throughput. Even just one of its 5 gigahertz bands offers up to 4,400 megabits per second in overall throughput, and that can be used as a way to connect to other client devices if they support it, and it can also be used as the wireless mesh backhaul for your mesh environment. And with that also, this RT6600AX router supports mesh Wi-Fi with other RT6600AX routers alongside of it. Keep in mind, this support will be expanded in the future to include other Synology routers in the future. Now, in addition to the Wi-Fi 6 standard approved in February 2021, the FCC also voted to free up more spectrum to general Wi-Fi users, specifically in the 5.9 gigahertz band. Now, extending unlicensed use to this band will effectively provide the first usable 160 megahertz wide Wi-Fi channel, and this is akin to having a Wi-Fi superhighway for routers. However, most Wi-Fi 6 routers on the market today cannot make full use of this 160 megahertz wide band, whereas the new Synology RT6600AX router is going to make full use of this channel upon its release. Now, for wire connection, multi-gigabit support has also become a more and more relevant topic in the past year. The Synology RT6600AX router has a 2.5 gigabit Ethernet port on the back of it, and it's configurable as WAN or LAN. Now, most other routers that have this port available to it, it's either specifically set as WAN or LAN, and you cannot actually configure that and change it as you need. However, on the Synology router, you could utilize it as a WAN port to meet multi-gigabit broadband plans, or it could be used as LAN connecting to other devices that support 2.5G, or it can also be used as a wired mesh backhaul to help remove any bottlenecks for devices that might be configured and connected down the line. The RT6600AX router will open up a new segment in the Synology router line, in addition to the existing RT2600AC and MR2200AC routers. We expect to release it sometime in the first half of 2022, together with SRM 1.3. However, this does not mean we're going to be forgetting users of our MR2200AC router, of the RT2600AC, or users of SRM with those devices. We believe that the level of advanced security powered by SRM 1.3 should become the default standard on all routers to come. So in 2022, the two current models will also be able to upgrade to this version. In the meantime, you can expect this product line will continue to evolve and expand to make sure that users from different segments with different considerations like a different number of devices, Wi-Fi coverage, or budget can all find the best Synology router to meet their needs. That about wraps up the Synology 2022 Connect session. Be sure to check out the other videos in this series because they do not disappoint. Take care.